Dear friends,
welcome to my channel.
We will solve some problems on time value of money. First problem is like this. Find the present value of the following cash flow streams if the interest rate is 1%. Calculation is like this: 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. After 1 year, we get $400. Then $400. Then $300 and $200. So overall present value will be the present value of individual money which we are getting. See, we get money after 1 year $400, after 2 years $400, after 3 years $300, after 4 years. So we know that FV is equal to PV 1 plus I, or PV is equal to FV upon 1 plus I. See, for this, let us say PV 1 will be equal to future value is 400 and I is 1%, that is 1 by 100. Or 400 by 2.01. So PV 2 will be equal to similarly divided by 1.01 square. PV 3 will be equal to divided by 1.01 raised to the power 3. And PV 4 will be equal to 200 divided by 1.01 raised to the power 4. So overall present value will be equal to PV equal to PV 1 plus PV 2 plus PV 3 plus PV 4. 400 divided by 1.01 plus 400 divided by 1.01 square plus 300 divided by 1.01 t plus is to the power 4. By solving this, we get 471.53 will be present value of all these cash flow streams. So let us see another problem, second problem. Like this, find future value at the end of 6 years of $1,000. Invested today the interest rate is
11%.
Dear friends, we know
F equal to EV 1 plus I raised to the power n. FV, we have to find out FV. EV is 1000, I is 11%, equal to 0.11, and n is 6 years.
So, putting this value, we get FV equal to 1001 plus 0.11 raised to the power 6. By solving this, we get 1870.41. See, there are four unknowns in this equation, 1, 2, 3 and 4. If we know any 3, we can calculate the 4. Here FE is being calculated. Let us see third problem. Find the future value of an LUD of $300 per year if for 11 years if I equal to 4%. See, we have to calculate this value for 11 years. So we will use formula. FV, we have FV is equal to PMT 1 plus I raised to the power n minus 1 divided by I. See, we can use this formula if cash flows or every year is remaining same. If this cash flow changes, then we cannot use this formula. We have to find out the future value of individual investment and then add. See, here FV is to be calculated. EMT is 300 and every year $300 is being deposited. I equal to 4%. N equal to 11, because every year we are depositing 300 and we have to find out every year after 11 years. Hence, FV equal to 300, 1 plus 0.04 raised to the power 11 minus 1 divided by 0.04. If we calculate it, we get future value as 0.045.91. So this is how we can calculate the future value of this n. Let us see in fourth problem. For three years, if I equal to 17%. See, here this annuity is only for 3 years, so we can calculate this present value by using direct method. See, after 1 year we are getting 700, after second year again we are getting 700. After third year we are getting again 700.
So present value we can write like this, equal to 700 equal to 1.17, because it is 17%. This is the present value of the money which we will be getting after first year. And this will be future value of 700 which we will get after 2 years. Plus 700 divided by 1.17 raised to the power 3. If we calculate it, we get 1546.71.
See, this future value we can calculate using formula also.
Sorry, present value. Present value we have to calculate because we are getting payment, we are not depositing. So we have to use this formula, PMT 1 minus 1 plus I raised to the power minus n divided by I. Here PV is to be calculated, PMT equal to 700, I equal to 7.17 and n is equal to 3, right? 3 years we are at. So PV will be equal to 700, 1 minus 1.17 minus 3 divided by 0.17. If we calculate this, we will get 1546.71.
So dear friends, if number of years or number of periods is less, say up to 5, we can find out the present value using direct that formula. If this number of periods goes beyond 5 or so, then we should use formula only, because it becomes easy to use it. Calculating using the direct method is cumbersome, and there will be so many terms, calculation will take a lot of time. So this formula is generally used if this number of periods goes beyond 5. Let us see one more problem on this time value of money. Problem is, find SP at the end of 15 years of $200 invested today. If I is 12%, see here this investment is made only once, so we can use this formula. F is equal to PV 1 plus I raised to the power n. Here F is to be found out, PV is 200 and I is equal to 12% equal to 0.12 and n is equal to 15 years. So FV will be equal to 200 1 plus 0.12 raised to the power 15. We will get this 1094.71. This is how we can calculate FV if there is only one time investment. Dear friends, thank you for visiting my video. Kindly like and share it with your friends. Further, kindly subscribe to my channel if you like my channel. Like my video. Thank you very much.